Hello and welcome back to the Satanic Media Agenda Exposed with Michael in Germany, who made this wonderful script of 631 pages. And now we are on page 531, 100 pages to go, Michael.
Yeah, thank you, Brett. Thank you, dear listeners. I think we are about now session 12 on David Bowie. And I think we cannot handle 100 pages in one row. But nevertheless, going back into David Bowie as one of the prophets of the Satanic Media Agenda Exposed. Yes, this is just one example. This is a lonely man who wanted to achieve stardom because he gained no reputation from his parents. I think that's to sum it up. But yeah, you see, this is all about the tricks that Satan pulls out to deceive people into believing themselves that they can become as gods, as the snake promised to Eve in the Garden of Eden. So moving on into the next page. Yeah, you see that most of these artists are actually then kind of possessed by evil spirits because they have to achieve their inspiration, because they got pressure from the record companies. They have to make it big time on the big scale, selling records, doing promotion, etc., etc. And I just came up with the idea to present the band called Possessed. You see the image of the downward cross and the 666 with the snake or the dragon tail here. Yeah, this is all these guys are really also using these V-shaped guitars here, which is also a kind of a horn, yeah, which depicts also a satanic guitar, if you prefer to see it that way. Yeah, you see here also this monster image here, this vow, vow, vow also means 666. So yes, yeah, all these hidden things, also the color here, prominent color is black, red, yeah, the color of Satanism. Okay, this is just a brief excerpt. This is about death metal. And the group Possessed here, it has been claimed to be the inventors of the item death metal, because their song death metal actually was the beginning of the era of death metal. And in my opinion, it's totally wrong. But you see that speaking of the Satanic Media Exposed, we look take a close look. Or quick look at the lyrics. Arise from the dead, attack from the grave, the killing won't stop till the first light, we'll bring you to hell because we want to enslave, your soul will be frozen with fright, we break through the crust. So if you are looking to some nice lyrics, please go look anywhere else. Yeah? Look anywhere else. Yeah, the song is called Death Metal, and it's repeated here in the rhyme. Yeah, death metal, ruining your cities, controlling your towns, entrapped in your worst nightmare, piercing your ears with a horrible sound. Yeah, I can really confirm that. Yeah, Lucifer laughs. Yeah, Lucifer has the last laugh. Yeah, people are killed, etc., etc. Death metal, kill them pigs, now we take over and rule by death metal. Yeah. Problem is that death metal is just a name. And death metal is just a song by the song called by the group Possessed. Yeah, so they really confirm that they are possessed. That's great, huh? You don't have to look very much deeper. Yeah, they confirm it to you already.
Quite but shallow, see, yes.
Yeah, but actually, death metal means another thing. Yeah, because death metal is anything that kills a human or a human body with metal, which is a knife or a bullet. This is death metal. But that they won't tell you, of course. So rushing through the script. This is a symbol of the rock music with death metal. This is actually the devil's horn or the Manu Cornuta sign. Yeah, and this has been depicted today or described today as a fry fork. Yeah, in German Pommesgabel, but French fries, you know that French fries, you pick it up on the fork. Yeah, this is the fork. Yeah, if you think that the fork has left the middle tip here. Yeah, so they call it the fries fork to deceive people. Yeah. So actually, most of the people know this is a symbol of Satan, but they don't care because they are in the spirit of Antichrist, if you see here.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. This is the spirit of Antichrist. Huh?
It's all fun and games to them.
Yeah, of course. These are the winners of the Metal Battle 2017, the Mexican band called Jaguar. Yeah, you remember the Jaguar from the picture of the cover of Roxy Music for Your Pleasure with Amanda Lear. Yeah, and they all are in the spirit of Antichrist. These people do not listen to that episode we are now currently recording.
More than likely not.
They all eat French fries, obviously. Yeah, it's just a joke, yeah? And you see, yeah. Possessed is coming from the, in German, it's called possessed, or it's called a possessive pronomen. Yeah, it's a name for a term in the German language, which indicates possession. Yeah, this is mine. Yeah, this is yours, this is mine, this is a possessive pronoun. Yeah, is that your cat? Yes, that's mine. Yeah, mine. Yeah, so to be possessed means that another spirit has taken over the possession of your soul.
Oh, that's interesting you say that like that, Michael. I just want to add, you know, I moved out of Minneapolis, St. Paul, up here to just north, about 45 minutes of that area where I grew up. And, you know, one of the interesting things, Mike, when I first moved up here, I really liked the sign on the road. There was a sign on the road in someone's land, personal land that they own. And the sign on the road said something to the regards of, be sure that your possessions do not possess you.
Mm-hmm.
And that stuck with me, and they took that sign down some years ago, but I always miss it. I was like, you know, that's true. Possessions will possess you if you get so obsessed with them, people can accuse me of being satanic because I play music and that I use a synthesizer and that I am in the spirit of the devil because I use these tools. No, it's simply another tool, like a computer is a tool. And, you know, we might have these possessions now, but they're not going to be with us in God's eternal kingdom. They're just tools, like a computer is a tool. And these tools can be used either in ways that bring glory to Christ, or they bring glory to the replacement for Christ. And I think that's what we're getting to, Michael, is they've chosen, the merchants of the earth have chosen to indoctrinate us into a lie. And they want us to be joining them in the lie and to, you know, perpetrate this lie on the world. And that's what everyone's, getting in line with. You know, the whole movement is to subvert, is to infiltrate, is to take over from within. And, you know, yeah, these songs like this. Okay, so we got Daniel 7:25. I will read that here.
Yeah.
Just quick look it up here.
Yeah, it's because that all these people are following the Satanic Media Agenda are also the visitors of these so-called death metal concerts.
7:25, correct?
Yeah.
And he shall speak great words against the Most High and shall wear out the saints of the Most High and think to change times and laws, and they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of time.
Mm. Yeah, and you see, these satanic lyrics, possess, death metal, etc., yeah, these actually are 7:25, that he will speak against the Most High. Yeah, and these people who are visiting these contests, these satanic preachers, they're all in line. These are the followers of Satan. These are the followers of Satan's merchants, and Satan's merchants are these people who are making this satanic death metal music. It's more obvious, of course, than David Bowie. But in the end, it all comes down to nitty-gritty that they all are in the spirit of Antichrist. It doesn't...
But the strange thing is, Michael, they think it's fun.
Mm.
They really, really think this is a fun thing to do, and it's enjoyable to blaspheme the name of Christ in the way that they do and in the manner that they do. But yet they go to church on Sunday and they supposedly read their Bibles. It's strange in America what's happened. But, you know, when you look into Freemasonry and you look at all the different orders, they all go back to the same root. And that root is the Catholic Church, the universal, quote unquote, kingdom of Christ, which is a lie. It's the replacement for Christ.
Yeah, and this is Brian Eno again on the left side and David Bowie on the right side. David Bowie's longtime friend Brian Eno revealed poignant final email. I realized now he was saying goodbye. David Bowie's death on Sunday came as a huge shock to many, but the musical icon had begun to say his farewells before his passing. His longtime friend and collaborator, Brian Eno, has revealed that he was in contact with David just last week and believes the star had been saying goodbye. Brian, who produced the singer's Berlin trilogy, told the BBC that David's death came as a complete surprise, as did nearly everything else about him. I feel a huge gap now, he added. Okay. We knew each other for more than 40 years. I received an email from him 7 days ago. It was as funny as always and as surreal, looping through word games and illusions and all the usual stuff we did. It ended with this sentence: thank you for our good times, Brian. They will not rot. And it was signed Dawn. I realized now he was saying goodbye. Why did he sign it with Dawn? Well, Dawn is a code word for Lucifer. You see it in several pictures here. Lucifer, bright sun on the dawn. Yeah, because so Lucifer is being called the morning star, or because the Venus, as it is the first star and the brightest star in the morning sky, was to be a synonym for Lucifer. And so there's the Venus as the morning star and the evening star also. So this means that all things who are connected to dusk or dawn are code words for the Venus. And the Venus as the most beautiful and most brightest star is a code word for Lucifer, for the sun, for the light bearer. The sun, the so-called sun of the morning. So, look at that. Dawn of Lucifer, Transport League, or Kate Bush, Before the Dawn, or Pink Floyd, The Piper at the Gates of Dawn. The Piper at the Gates of Dawn is also an old fairy tale of the United Kingdom, but you see that the Piper is related to Ezekiel 28:13. Thy pipes and thy tabrets were created in the day, etc. Yeah, it's about Lucifer. The piper, pipes, gates of dawn. it's all about Lucifer. It's a worship of Lucifer. And also for Pink Floyd, it's quite obvious. I did several episodes in German about Shine On Your Crazy Diamond. It's all about Lucifer. It's not about Syd Barrett. It's about Lucifer. As well as the Beatles' Lucifer and the Sky with Diamonds. Huh? It's also Ezekiel 28:13. Yeah? All these precious stones, also the diamonds around it. And David Bowie did lyrics in 1971. We had that before, several episodes before, where he said in the lyrics of his song Quicksand, I'm closer to the Golden Dawn. And the Golden Dawn is an order of the 20th century of the 19th century, and then transformed into the OTO of Aleister Crowley. And everything else is about the dawn. The dawn is a Codeword for Lucifer. This is a symbol of the golden dawn. And also, this is a lie. Lucifer means light bearer and morning star. No. Lucifer only means light bearer because it looks for light and fairer for bearing. Yeah, so it's a combination. Light bearer is a combination of light and bearer, and Lucifer is also looks and fairer. Yeah, so it's a combination word. It does not mean morning star in the first place. The morning star is here depicted as Venus, but it is not necessary. Lucifer does not mean morning star. Morning star is just a pagan description of the events taking place in heaven, and the brightest star is the Venus, and the Venus therefore was being seen as a symbol for Lucifer. Yeah, that's so this sentence is not correct. In pre-Christian mythology, and there is no Christian mythology also, but he is called Shahar-Hilel and Esphoros, or Dawn Bearer. He is not the fallen angel, this is another lie, or a name for the devil, but the morning aspect of the planet Venus. I have pointed that out, yeah, that Lucifer has been seen as the brightest star. He was so bright, he was perfect in the days he was created, until iniquity was found in him. So he is a fallen angel. Venus is also personified as a goddess called Aphrodite in Greek. This is correct, this sentence. There is no need to fear Lucifer Venus. This sentence here is a little bit mixed of the holy and the profane. It has to be read like this. There is no need to fear Lucifer if you got the Holy Spirit and believe in the Jesus Christ being the Son of God.
Yeah. That's a good way to put it, yeah.
Yeah. So truthbeknown.com, yeah, does not tell you the truth.
Well, you know, Michael, if there is two different schools of thought, such as the Gnostic school, if you will, and the Bible school, if you will, you know, the Protestant school, if you will, and the Catholic school, if you will. This is the Catholic truth that they will end up in the lake of fire. So if they follow these teachings, you know, do as thou wilt shall be the whole of the law. And go have your fun then, I guess, because I can't stop you.
And this could also be derived from the Lucifer's publishing company. If you look upon the logo on the top of the page here with the pentagram, Luciferian pentagram, yeah, you see that this all kind of subtle lies here. Yeah, you can easily be betrayed because you think that they are smart, they are using
this is not the truth in Jesus Christ, Michael. Mm. Obviously, right?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, moving on with Dawn. Because you see, actually, we are going into that subject because David Bowie was signing his email as Dawn. D-A-W-N. Lucifer at daybreak. Yeah, California at the dawn of the Third World War. Yeah, but the serpent was more subtle than any other beast of the field. For example, Cat Stevens has been renamed to Yusuf Islam because then he was changing his religious belief into the Islam. And some of his famous songs is Morning Has Broken. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Blackbird? Blackbird, anyone? Kate Bush? The Raven? Genesis? The Lamp Lies Down on Broadway? Anyone? Blackbird? Remember some episodes ago, sunlit from the heaven like the first dew fall on the first grass, praise on the sweetness on the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet pass. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light Eden saw play. Yeah? Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's creation of the new day. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning. Mm-hmm. If you think, you know that he's not Christian because he was then changing his name to Yusuf Islam. So that's, at least I think, all you need to know about the song. Morning Has Broken is about the creation and God's creation of the new day. Okay. Mm-hmm. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them. Yeah, but where's the praise for Jesus Christ? Where's the praise for the Almighty Lord? You won't find anything. So don't be fooled. Don't be confused with the so many names of Satan. And this is just a brief overview. This is not a complete list. Now, he's called Beelzebul, ruler of demons, Lucifer, morning star, light bearer, son of dawn, devil, serpent, wicked one, evil, god of this world, ruler of this world, prince of the power of the air, murderer from the beginning, liar, father of lies, etc., etc., etc. It's just one thing. It's the adversary of God. Yeah, this you have to know. Yeah, it's the adversary of God, and it's the adversary of Jesus Christ.
I see the little Roman numeral V there.
Yeah, yeah.
That's five, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Five eyes of Lucifer.
Yeah. Yeah. You see that between sunset and sunlight, there's twilight. And twilight is then when the sun is not shining anymore, or not yet, yeah, but here, this is in between, yeah, between night and day. This is twilight, yeah. And if you want to know if the Electric Light Orchestra is satanic, I would say, yes, it is. Yes, it is. Because you see that if you go into live session now here, if you go into the lyrics of ELO, prologue, lyrics from the famous album Time, yeah, you will not believe your eyes. Just on the border of your waking mind, there lies another time where darkness and light are one, speaking of the twilight zone. And as you treat the halls of sanity, you feel so glad to be unable to go beyond. I have a message from another time, yeah, where darkness and light are one. Okay, we can move on, but my computer does not like that. So, ELO Twilight. You know that Twilight Zone is a horror series. Once was a horror series. So, ELO Twilight. Where is it? The early dawn, the shades of time, twilight crawling through my window pane. Am I awake or do I dream? The strangest pictures I have seen. Night is day and twilight's gone away. With your head held high and your scarlet lies, you came down to me from the open skies. I think that's sufficient, isn't it? Yeah. So this is ELO, and you can shut down the files on ELO also. Going back to David Bowie. So we see from dusk, it's dusk here, and this is dawn. Yeah, you know that movie? From dusk to dawn. Why are they using a silver revolver in the 1990s movie? I can tell you, because the silver revolver is about revolution, because here the drum is revolting or changing every time you press the trigger, then it moves around the next chamber with the next bullet is been pressed here, etc., etc. Silver revolver is a synonym for the revolution of Lucifer. Yeah, you remember the silver key lying below the golden key in the flag of the Vatican. Yeah, from dusk to dawn. How are you falling? This is not a correct Bible verse here. From heaven, O morning star, son of the dawn. You see, some of the Bibles also contain the verse son of the dawn. Yeah, you see, it's dawn is the code word for Lucifer. Yeah, this is the NIV, this is the KJV. I have not checked it out if everything is correct, but I know that is how art thou fallen. I know that 100%. Son of the morning. And here in the NIV, it's called the morning star. And don't think that they have even mentioned here Lucifer. This is the new version. Yeah. And in Revelation 22:16, you can read it up, Brad. Then Jesus Christ claims who he is.
Yeah. Revelation 22:16, which I will look up.
Please.
Quickly, hopefully. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify unto you these things in the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, the bright and morning star.
Yeah.
So they're switching around Jesus with Lucifer in the NIV. Yeah. Gee, I wonder why they would do that, Michael.
Yeah, because most of the people fall into the trap on the Broadway, which led to destruction. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because we need a Bible that's more up to date. You see, we can't deal with the old King James. It's just too old. And we need to revise it so that it's modern.
Mm-hmm.
How stupid.
Yeah. If you change the truth, it isn't the truth anymore.
That's right.
This is one of the last lyrics on David Bowie, The Next Day. They whip him through the streets and alleys there, the gormless and the baying crowd right there. They can't get enough of that doomsday song, they can't get enough of it all. Listen to the horse, he tells her, etc., etc. This is, you see, these are the things David Bowie is singing about. I really don't like to go of his women dressed as men for the pleasure of that priest. I think we can, not quite dying, I think we can skip that, because you see that on the gallows for me. Yeah. They can work with Satan while they dress like the saints. Speaking of whom? Speaking of whom? They can work with Satan while they dress like the saints. The real man in black. They know God exists, for the devil told them so. So they speak to the devil. Yeah, this is David Bowie. This is really weird stuff he did.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, nevertheless, we are approaching the finishing line here. Mm-hmm. We're not quite there, but we're on page 550. This is this last album, Black Star, published 2 days before his death. Depicting here a Luciferian pentagram and his own last name, family name here, Bowie, in a kind of a star type.
Michael, maybe we should save this one for next time.
Okay.
We'll cut the session today because we're already, are we an hour about? I don't know.
No, we are 28 minutes.
Oh, that's not too bad. Then we can finish it up, maybe?
Shall we proceed next time?
We can.
Yeah, we can, of course.
We'll make a short one because I think this requires some, I mean, to me, this signature here that you just pointed out, you have the B, the O, the W, and then the I and the E. Well, if you take this I and you make a cross with it, guess what? You have the Maltese cross.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's correct. Yes. Mm-hmm.
And the also, Knights also, of Malta are probably the most influential and insidious group that's ever been on the face of the earth, I might say, because the history behind them is just jaw-dropping, Michael. 900 years of them.
Hmm.
Plus.
It's also interesting that the eye also, this is a symbol here for the, what is it in English? This series about the universe with Captain Kirk and Mr. Spock.
Star Trek.
Yeah, this is similar for Star Trek also.
Or Pontiac, if you flip it upside right up. It's a Pontiac symbol for the car in America here. Yep.
Okay, we can do another hour whatever, and then have a usual episode next time. That's no problem.
Sounds good. Okay.